Catherine Wu has taken decisive strides towards one of the most important goals in cancer research, the development of a cancer vaccine. This is a scientific breakthrough for which Dr. Catherine Wu is awarded the 2024 Sjöberg Prize.
This represents a huge breakthrough in cancer research. Catherine Wu's work makes it possible to generate personalized vaccines to large groups of patients with cancer.
This is great progress that could become an important treatment option in many types of cancer, including cancer types that are currently incurable.
Melanoma, a type of skin cancer, is one of the most common and most threatening types of cancers. It is a disease for which treatments have improved, but where additional treatment strategies are needed.
I had a mole that had become very itchy, and it turned out to be melanoma. But I was lucky. I received a treatment that worked. But unfortunately, it doesn't work well for every patient. So there is a real need for new treatment.
Improving outcomes for patients with melanoma, as well as for other types of cancers that do not currently have effective treatments, is exactly what Catherine Wu's research has focused on. A tumor is made of cells that are dividing and growing uncontrollably. Over time, the tumor's cells collect mutations, faults in their DNA. Our immune system often has difficulty recognizing these cancer cells, but if it is helped to identify them, it can attack the cancer. Catherine Wu is an oncologist and hematologist. She has led a research team at the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute in Boston since 2000. Her research into cancer roused her interest in finding new ways to help the immune system recognize tumors. Wu entered an entirely new field of research. Her goal was to develop a therapy that strengthens the immune system in which the patient receives a personalized vaccine based on the small changes in the tumor cell's DNA. As a tumor grows, small genetic mutations often occur in its cells. These lead to proteins in the tumor being slightly different to those in healthy cells. The altered proteins generate tumor neoantigens, structures that can be recognized by the immune system's T cells. Wu has succeeded in characterizing these neoantigens and showing which ones are on the cell's surface, making it possible to create patient-specific cancer vaccines.
This is a fantastic discovery. The ability to identify neospecific tumor antigens has really developed into a large field of cancer research, as it offers the possibility to generate tumor-specific cancer vaccines. Catherine Wu is undoubtedly a pioneer in this field.
In the next stage, Wu developed a prototype for a tumor-specific cancer vaccine. A number of the patient's tumor neoantigens were produced in the laboratory for use as a vaccine. These neoantigens were injected into the patient. They activated the immune system, which was now able to discover the cancer cells, attack them, and in some cases, destroy the tumor.
What makes this treatment exceptional is that it builds upon one patient's tumor and the cancer cell's unique characteristics to produce a tumor-specific vaccine. And this is a wonderful example of a personalized treatment strategy.
So this is, of course, research which is in its early stage of development. But excitingly, we are already now seeing responses in certain forms of cancer that have been considered to be almost incurable. And with these promising results, it will be really exciting to see where this field will take us in the coming 5 to 10 to 15 years.
Camilla Lindfors received 2 years of standard treatment for her skin cancer. and it disappeared.
I was lucky enough to belong to the group that respond to that treatment. However, there are people who don't. So this is a vital milestone on the road to developing a cancer vaccine for melanoma. This gives me hope in case the cancer does return.
This research really raises the hope that we will be able to offer vaccine in numerous types of cancer in the future.
Catherine J. Wu is awarded the 2024 Sjöberg Prize for discoveries concerning tumor neoantigens and the immune response to tumor cells as a basis for cancer vaccine development.
Well, I was in my office at work, and I was stunned. It's such a mixture of emotions, right? So ranging from speechlessness to disbelief to immense gratitude. I'm incredibly grateful for the prize, but I also recognize that this has also been a shared vision. I'm leading a group. We've been working together for more than 10 years on this work, and so it's immensely, just so immensely grateful. I'm very hopeful in the next few years that we'll see that these impacts will really, really be seen across broad populations of people, and that it can become part of our standard offerings to make a difference for our patients.
The Sjöberg Prize is awarded by the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences and financed by the Sjöberg Foundation.